Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So, in the spirit of what is now summer, it is the beginning of July, I thought I would tell you guys some tips and tricks to taking care of a dog during summertime when the weather's hot, when things are heating up. Let's get to this. Tip number one is whether you are at home with your dog or out and about with your dog, make sure you have access always to clean, cold water. You don't want your dog to dehydrate, just like you don't want yourself to dehydrate. So make sure your dog is always hydrated with some fresh water to keep them cool, keep them going, and keep them healthy. Tip number two is if you are out and about and going anywhere with your dog, make sure you always find a place that is well shaded and well cool. So when your dog needs to sit around or chill around, whatever you and your dog are doing, that they have a nice shaded place to keep cool and keep away from the sun and the damages and the heat that can come with being left out in the sun. Tip number three, and this is a very, very important one, is make sure you never, ever, ever, under any circumstances, leave your dog alone in the car, especially unattended. People don't realize that within 10 minutes, your dog can get heat stroke and it can be really bad. And they have done research into how hot a car gets, and it gets extremely hot. If you don't want to be left out in the car in the heat with it turned off, just stuck in this insulated like oven type thing, don't put your dogs in there. It is also illegal in, forgot how many states, but it is illegal to leave your dog unattended in a car. If you do that, people have the right of way to break your car window, to get that dog out to safety, because it's basically animal abuse, guys. I'm saying if you have to quickly go into the store just to get something real quick, make sure you leave your car on and with the AC going to keep your dog cool. And that's if you must, and there's no other way, if you must keep your dog in the car and have to go somewhere, make sure the car is on and the air conditioning is going. Tip number four is if you have to take your dog out to a walk or anything during the summer day, make sure you are staying away from any pavement because the pavement can get very, very hot and dogs' paws and feet can be very, very sensitive to that. And there's a lot of cases of people's dogs like under their paws and that little padded area getting like burned and like severely like burned and hurt. So make sure you are staying away from any areas with hot pavement, or you can try to find little doggy socks and doggy shoes to put on your dog to help protect their feet. And make sure also as another preventative method and way is to maybe take the hose or take something and kind of pour some or spray some water, some cool water on their toes and their feet to keep their paws cool. Tip number five is make sure you keep your dog all caught up with any heartworm medication, any flea medications, anything that you need from the vet to prevent your dog from getting any infestations, getting any parasites in them, any bug bites, insect bites, any of that. Make sure your dog is all caught up with all the medication they need and all the things they need to prevent yucky summer bugs and insects and parasites from getting to your poor little dog. Tip number six is if you plan to take your dog out swimming, whether it's a lake, pool, whatever it might be, make sure you invest in getting a doggy life jacket. No matter how well you think that your dog is a great swimmer or he's doing really well, it can only take 1 second to put the dog in the water and for it to drown. So make sure you at least have it on hand if you need it, because the last thing you need is your poor little pet to drown. So make sure you always have the preventative methods in case you need them, and just to keep your dog safe altogether. And tip number seven, would be, especially around summertime, you have the 4th of July and you have a lot of cookouts and you have a lot of events with fireworks and loud noises. Make sure you try your best to keep your dog away from that to prevent them from getting too nervous and anxious and scared and all that. And if you guys do want to know more about how to take care of your dog or your pet during fireworks and the 4th of July and anything like that, I do have a video on my channel that I will link here and down below for you guys to check out if you want to see more of those tips and more of a longer version of how to take care of a pet during that. So that's all the tips I have for you guys on taking care of a dog during the summertime and how to make sure that both you and your dog are healthy and happy during this fun, eventful time of the year. If you guys like this, please make sure you give it a like, make sure to share to tell others about how to take care of their dog during the summertime. It might help them out. And if you're not already subscribed, please feel free to subscribe. It's that red button down below. Make sure you hit that ding-a-ling-a notification bell to be notified every time I make a new video. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.